Students, hope you all fine and safe. Today, we are going to learn the topic which is very relevant to our present situation. Now, we all know this current situation we are facing and fighting against coronavirus. Doctors and other medical experts insisting few advices to prevent the spread of coronavirus. As we all know and we are listening to the many medias. But still, I wanted to recall and insist again. Few of the tips are: clean your hands often, use soap and water, maintain a safe distance from anyone who is coughing or sneezing. Don't touch your eyes, nose or mouth. Cover your nose and mouth with your bent elbow or a tissue when you cough or sneeze. From the above instructions, we can understand it is very important to have a personal hygiene and keeping our surroundings clean. It will help us to save ourselves from any health issues. So, I expect that each one of us should follow these preventive measures in our daily life. I would like to introduce the topic which we are going to learn today. My body. My body. In this lesson, we are going to cover these objectives. That is, benefits of hand washing, importance of self-hygiene, using toilets and avoiding open defecation, precautions to protect the sense organs. First, we want to know about cleanliness. What is cleanliness, children? Yes, cleanliness is nothing but being clean and neat, isn't it? We all like to be clean and neat to see, isn't it? Yes? Yes. In the cleanliness, we are going to learn about hand washing, using toilets and bathing. Why we have to be clean always? Yes, to protect ourselves from the diseases or any other infections caused by germs. You know what are germs? Germs are nothing but they are the microorganisms that are present in all the places which can affect our body, isn't it? What are germs? Yes, germs are microorganisms. It can be present in all the places. Yes, children? Yes. Next, why first we want to learn about hand washing, isn't it? Okay, here you can see a picture of germy hand. Is it looking beautiful? No. Anyone like this diagram? No. Yes. Actually, see, when you're washing your hands without any proper techniques, you will be avoiding the germs which is present in the edges, in the foldings or in the corners. So, when you're washing your hands, you have to use your proper way of hand washing. As we see nowadays in the TV and WhatsApps and many videos, they are showing the techniques of washing your hands, isn't it? Yes. I'll also post you a picture, a diagram which have the step-by-step the hand washing techniques, isn't it? Okay. Okay, children, we'll continue. Okay, this is the about the hand washing, isn't it? So, proper way of using washing techniques will keep us healthy, isn't it? Yes. So, do you know the World Health Day is observed on April 7th? Next, we want to know the benefits of hand washing. Yes. First, benefits of hand washing: kill or remove germs. It will help you to lower the risk of diseases like diarrhea, prevent eye infections, reduce the risk of respiratory infections. You know, children, Global Hand Washing Day is observed on October 15th. Yes. Already we have all these celebration days, but we never know all these things. Until this coronavirus, we doesn't know about the hand washing techniques. So, at least now we'll come to know this Global Hand Washing Day is observed on October 15th. Next, we want to go about the benefits of hand washing. I'll explain you when you are cleaning your hands with the proper way of techniques of hand washing, it will kill or remove the germ. So you will have a clean hands, isn't it? So automatically it will lower the risk of diseases like diarrhea, or it will prevent the eye infections. Through the hands only, we'll be getting most of the infections. Through the hand, when we are touching your eyes, it will get into your eyes and it will get infected. Next, reduce the risk of respiratory infections. This is the best word. Now you can relate it with the coronavirus. Now, how the doctors are telling? The doctors are telling that when you are having the coronavirus in your hands, it may, when you are touching your eyes, nose or mouth, it may go inside your windpipe and it will settle down in your lungs, and this will give you the heaviness in the breathing, and this will give you the respiratory infection and leads to the severe respiratory disorders, isn't it? Yes. Okay, coming back to the topic, next we are going to know about using toilets. You know, children, in the world, nearly 1 billion people have no access of toilets. They don't have toilets in their house. Is it feeling very bad, isn't it? Yes, even I too feel the same. They are forced to use the open defecation. What is open defecation, children? Yes, going toilet in the open place. Gee, bad, bad, bad. Yes, yes. Okay. We know this is wrong method and wrong thing to do in the open places. So, open defecation spreads diseases such as cholera and diarrhea. The groundwater is polluted by toilets and it's also caused diseases. Children also get affected by intestinal worms, which caused by anemia. How you can ask? When we are doing our open defecation, how we are getting the water pollution? Open defecation spreads diseases such as cholera and diarrhea. Groundwater is polluted by toilets and it also causes diseases. Children also get affected by intestinal worms, which causes anemia. Effects of open defecation. Waterborne diseases, diseases caused by insect carrier, pollution. Do you know, children, National Deworming Day is observed on February 10th. Next, we are going to move on to bathing. Importance of bathing. Cleanses the body. It helps to clean your body. Removes dirt and odor. You feel fresh, isn't it, when you are getting rid of your dirt, sweat or the smell that we called as odor. We feel very fresh, isn't it? Yes. Next, protect oneself from infections. When you are clean, you are clean and free from the germs. Next, it will be improving your blood circulation. Protecting sense organs. What are sense organs, children? We have 5 sense organs, isn't it? Yes. First, we want to see about eyes. Eyes. Nowadays, we are using our smartphones, TV or video games or monitors or whatever it is, all causes the digital eye strain, isn't it? The digital eye strain is very common among the people working at computers all day. This condition leads to dry eyes, eye strain, blurred vision and headache. So, what we have to be done? Yes. Read with proper light. Next, watch television from minimum distance of 6 feet. If you feel your eyes are itchy, wash them with clean and cold water. Please do not rub your eyes. Yes. Next, we are going to see about ears. Do not clean your ears with earbuds. Never try to use your earbuds to clean inside the ears. Okay, children? Yes. Next, dry your ears after taking bath. Do not listen to music at high volume when you are using earphones or headphones. When you are using even the song when you are playing or watching TV also, please avoid maximum volume and always pleasant to listen a very moderate sound, isn't it? Yes. Next, consult a doctor if you have a pain in your ears. Don't do any other home remedy works. Next, her nose. Do not clean your nose by inserting any object into it. If the nose is blocked due to the cold, it is better to use steam to clean it. Nose. Do not clean your nose by inserting any object into it. If the nose is blocked due to cold, it is better to use steam to clear it. Do not pick your nose. Tongue. If we should clean our tongue daily with the tongue cleaner while brushing our teeth. A dirty tongue may cause diseases and bad breath. The last one, skin. Take bath daily. Always use a mild soap. Keep your skin dry and clean. Dry your skin by rubbing gently with the clean cloth. Okay, by this we have completed the lesson for the first session. Okay, children? Okay, now I would like to give you a worksheet from this content. First, we want to go for this match the following. We are going to do this match the following. World Health Day, Global Washing Day, National Deworming Day, World Toilet Day. These are the days I have written here and I have mismatched the dates here. Match this two in a correct way. Next, another activity is, we are going to draw germy hand. You saw the germy hand which I have drawn in my book, isn't it? You better trace your hand in a white sheet or a note. You can color the germs in a different colors. Okay, children, we'll see in the next class. Bye. Thank you.